Oh, yes, sir. Well, definitely. The minute you mentioned it, that it was about dividing up the territories, like any gangsta operation.
Mm-hmm.
Gangsta operations at that Godfather level, what do? They divide up territories. The Italians will have a piece of this action. Barzini will have a piece of that action. The Corleones will have a piece. And Tessie over here, he'll have a piece. If you're familiar with the movie Godfather, which I keep referring to, and which I keep seeing on television all the time, because there's plenty of messages in that.
Yes.
Godfather 1 and 2, those two movies, are of Shakespearean, I say, longevity. I mean, in other words, they can teach that in school, replacing maybe some of the Shakespeare that they teach. And then, particularly among black people, because a lot of young black people want to be gangsters anyway, so they can relate to something like The Sopranos and The Godfather, but it will show that the system of white supremacy that governs them and their behavior, they are victims of this type of system, this gangster system at the top level called the system of white supremacy. It operates just like the Corleones and the Barzinis and the Tattaglias and the rest of those people that were named in Godfather 1 and 2. Hyman Roth and all of them, Johnny Ola, the senator that was bought off. Everybody was paying off, and he's making these excellent speeches and whatnot about this and that and the other, and shaking hands and whatnot, and taking money under the table. And doing all kinds of other things that in his so-called leadership position.
Sounds like today, doesn't it?
Sounds just like today, even though the movies were made in 1972, 1974. But that was happening before then, and it's been happening ever since. So you don't pay any attention to these titles either. Just watch what people do. Don't be fascinated by anybody's title.
Yes.
And this is important for black people. Get out of that habit. I don't care how many titles a person has in front of his or her name or behind his or her name. Pay attention to what's being done. Just about everything. See, in the Congo, even today, that's why the white supremacists don't want anybody going in there but them. As always, because that's a real harvester. The Congo is an excellent place to get all kinds of material that can be used all over the world. And you better believe the white supremacists are not going to concede one inch of it without a whole bunch of bloodshed against anyone non-white who tries to get anything out of Congo. I'll put it this way, when we start talking about the history of white supremacy, it will never, ever, ever be told, because there's no way for it to ever, ever, ever be known by anybody who's breathing now. There's no way for that history to ever be told.
Why do you say that?
Because it just wasn't recorded, most of it. Most of it was never put down on paper. I mean, and that includes the so-called slave trade, I mean, transatlantic slave. The history of the plantations will never, ever be told. All of the horrible things that went on year after year, decade after decade. Not for a few years, 4 or 5 years. I mean, some type of horrendous mistreatment of people. I'm talking about maybe as much as a couple of thousand years of non-stop brutality. Each and every day, bloodshed. Brutality, beatings, killings of every type. I mean, male, female, infants, throwing of, you know, babies into the ocean and whatnot for fun. Black babies. The white supremacists doing that and thinking nothing of it and having a swig of beer behind it, rum or whatever, and just having a party. In Australia, just running down the so-called Aborigines and shooting them like, you know, like rabbits. I mean, hey, just having fun. Just the good old boys. Like, I looked at, what, I turned on my TV, just flipped the channel yesterday. It's always there. And what was showing? Showboat. All right? And right in the middle of Showboat, it went right back to 1951, the black character in the movie, which is really the central part of the movie, singing what? Old Man River. You and me, we sweat and strain. Body all aching, racked with pain. Tote that barge, lift that bale. Get a little drunk and your land's in jail.